Located in suburban Chicago, MBL Recycling opened its state-of-the-art material recovery facility in 2005. Since then, millions of tons of material have been recovered and returned to the marketplace, with General Kinematics pitching in with primary and secondary finger screens, as well as a dual knife destoner. MBL has been able to continually grow their business since implementation, with an abundance of material to process and a total lack of downtime. MBL keeps right on growing.
MBL got started back in 2002. At the time, we're sorting literally on the ground. We had not any automation. And about 3 years into it, we moved to this facility in Palatine and we bought all of our equipment.
They actually happen to be a neighbor of ours here in Chicago. But beyond that, we really enjoy working with them to resolve simple sorting issues and brainstorm back and forth on how to optimize their process. Owner-operators like Rob and Wendy are real passionate about what they do, and we share in that passion and like to figure out how we can help improve that.
We just grew from one truck all the way up to 15 trucks right now, over 500 containers, 10s, 20s, 30s.
General Kinematics has provided the primary finger screen, the secondary finger screen, and the dual knife destoner on this sorting system.
Buying GK's equipment has been nothing but a blessing for us. Honestly, we have had literally no downtime. Usually we average every year about 135,000 tons come through the door.
It's important for General Kinematics to associate with all members that process the C&D materials to get a better understanding of what the challenges are region to region.
When we first started in 2002, and as I said, we had no automation, we just had manual labor on the ground. Compared to now, I mean, full circle, we can get 75% minimum. If it's new construction, we can even get higher than that.
The one upgrade that we made was on the secondary screen. They originally had a disc screen as a secondary screen, but over the years that was giving them a lot of problems and issues with the wrapping of plastics and other materials and getting caught up in the stars. So much so that they actually replaced the screen and we put in our secondary finger screen for that. So that takes out the fines portion of that, and it's greatly reduced their maintenance costs and downtime associated with the wrapping issue.
As far as the market, I see the C&D world nothing but good things. I really do. It just seems like it's one of those businesses that is always going to be around, whether people are remodeling or demolition or new construction.
We actually hit a big milestone with them after their 10-year anniversary and calculated they processed over 1 million tons of C&D across our equipment. And the primary finger screen still had the original finger decks installed from day one. We're looking for our equipment to be running for the long term. It's not just, you know, a one-shot deal and you're done. It's really that long-term relationships that we really value and highly prize.
Us working together over the last 15 years with GK has been wonderful. I mean, it goes both ways. The tight-knit family that we have with the C&D world is the same with GK and MBL Recycling.